tổ chức bóng đá đua, thế là không gì nữa, một cái bình của mình, đó là cái bình, tại vì anh không có 3G, tao khổ rồi đó.
Alo chị ơi.
Có 3G.
Chị Hiền ơi.
Đó, em được tổ chức bóng đá 3G. Em đứng lên mà, em thấy 3G anh. Em đứng gần đây, em nói cho em. Mô là tài mấy hàng, không phải mô, đúng không?
Cái chữ Creative Earth đọc sao? Hashtag
giờ nó đang đi từ đi xuống một. Chưa kết nối vô luôn. Tầm cái gì?
Thank you.
thôi chúng tôi tính ra luôn, quan trọng là việc đó có làm team sao đó. Kết nối điện thoại qua đi, bỏ qua cái đó, bỏ qua wifi sạch điện thoại đi. Tại vì quan trọng là tôi cần ốc nè. Bọn có một vạch nó mềm lực cái đó. Gió bọn vô này. Không vô được của ông nữa nè. Bên này mình cười, bên này không ai thấy. Rớt lại rồi. Hai mê, ba năm mê.
Thì ơi.
Rồi online, online.
Phải hiểu. Người ta không đi đứng này
được. Trời bình thường mày cũng dễ vô người ơi.
Rớt lại. Không vừa được cái nói được không?
Mít không có ăn dính
đầy. Mày dễ vô người. Cái đó kiểu ở dưới thế nào?
Hey AIESEC! You have 5 minutes to come back to the seat and settle down before we officially start. Come on! 5 minutes!
Giờ mới được, 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 Mấy sáu đêm vẫn bị cái này hôm đó, ông bị đã quay phim chưa? Ông bị đã quay phim chưa? Vẫn bị ngày hôm đó. Hả? Đứng ra lên lên. Không cảm giác bãi về giật giật không gì hết. Tập trung. Rồi rút đi.
Hey AIESEC! Give 5 minutes to come back to the seat and settle down before we officially start. Come on! 5 minutes! Not yet, not yet. Are you ready to start tonight? Are you ready to start tonight? Yes or no? Yes. 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 Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
No, we cannot start yet. Because we have a dance line tech dance. Let's dance!
Thank you.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone. I guess for many of you, that was the first AIESEC dance after so many years, right? Isn't it? Well, here's one more thing that you haven't done for a long time. Hey, AIESEC!
What's up?
Hey, AIESEC!
What's up?
How are you feeling?
Excellent!
How are you feeling?
Excellent!
How are you really, really, really feeling right now?
Fucking excellent!
Great! Well, okay. Now back to me. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Wing of the Choir, and I am former team leader from LC Ho Chi Minh City. It's been a pleasure and honor to be here. I remember when I received the call from Sabrina, she asked me to be the host for tonight's event, and I was excited, but at the same time, I was freaked out, like I am right now. I'm literally shaking here, not because how important it is to this event for us, for our organization, but also, before I came here, I was afraid. I was afraid that it's gonna be awkward. I was afraid that it's gonna be some family, like my own family reunion party, those party when you just come home and then there's like cousins and brothers and sisters that you don't really know. I was afraid it's gonna be like that, but the last hour seeing you guys have already bonded and already had a good time and your own spirit, thank you so much. I'm really proud and I really feel that we are here and we feel like we're at home. So thank you so much for being here and thank you so much for your spirit. And most of all, I'm also really proud to have one special person to be my companion tonight. Please welcome on stage, Đức An.
Really horrible. We eat dogs and cats and envy anymore. She rechanged her thinking about Vietnam. And I still remember my members crying with me and share that she has, like, AIESEC has completely changed her life, and she always lives the life that her parents want, but not really the life that she wants. And because of AIESEC, she has the courage to chase her dreams. So that was when I realized, like, AIESEC, we are just like a people business. In AIESEC, we are each other's friends, we are each other's teammates, and we are each other's teachers. We teach each other, and from that we grow. And I believe that in this room, that those were my stories, but in this room, everyone has their own version of an AIESEC story. And behind every AIESEC group, there is always a story. So maybe, like, we are different in ages, we are different in experience, we have a different AIESEC life, and we have, like, so different, like, in life's direction expectations, and also we may disagree with each other one thing or another, but I believe we all share one thing in common. That is, a part of our youth belongs to AIESEC. And to the organization that has a very big and ambitious dream. And in order to achieve that dream, we strive really hard, and sometimes, may I say, we failed also miserably. What's the word? We failed really hard as well. And we learned our lessons the hard way. But through all of those challenges and all of those difficulties, we grow. And we are not afraid of the challenges, we're embracing them. And we stay in AIESEC. We love AIESEC not because AIESEC experience is easy, but because it is extremely hard. And that's the reason, I guess, why I love this organization that much. So tonight, we are here to celebrate, to look back, to think about the journey that we've been through together. We are here to thank AIESEC, to thank each other, to thank the journey that we've been through. It has been 10 years since AIESEC appears in this country, and it has been 10 years since AIESEC creates many, many life-changing experiences for me, for you, for hundreds, thousands of Vietnamese youth across this country. So we are here tonight, once again, welcome to the celebration of 10th year Embracing Challenges. Welcome to the 10th year celebration of Youth of Impact Making. Welcome, AIESECers. Welcome, you home.
That was beautiful. I mean, your speech. Okay, but before we can actually celebrate what we have been through, what we have overcome, and also what we have achieved, we would like to show our deep appreciation. That was beautiful. Coming together and welcome on stage, Ms. Phan Hai, HR and Communication Manager of Prudential Vietnam.
Ah!
and we do a lot of activity, a lot of things, engage in a lot of like events with all the students in Vietnam especially. But this is a first time ever. We have a honey to support AIESEC, support a young, a youth organization to celebrate a internal and a big event like tonight. So we really would like to send a big celebration to all AIESEC current here. We know that for the past 10 years, AIESEC has been, not just in Vietnam, but in many countries, you have shown your passion, you your dream, you your small body to tell the world, to say to the world that young people can do many things together. And we can believe that leadership is a fundamental solution to world peace. I'm so proud that I can support with AIESEC and go together with you guys, even just 2 years into that journey. It's really meaningful and very joyful, for just not just for Rachel, but even for me. I saw that AIESEC do a lot of things through your work, through your volunteering, through your CHI event, and many, many more for students. And it's just like, I'm so proud that in Prudential, when I work with, we have so many AIESEC in Prudential as well. So it was so flattering and so joyful that we hope that, you know, tonight, I just want to say one word, that everyone live your night to the fullest, okay? Yeah. We hope that AIESEC and AIESEC Vietnam gonna, through your dream, show your passion, show your inspiration to the whole new world, that the young people can do so many more things than the people think. That for the next 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, and many, many more. And we hope that Prudential can join that journey with you as long as we can, and as much as we can as well. So happy birthday, AIESEC. Happy birthday to everyone here.
Thank you so much to you and also to Prudential for your generosity and for your sharing. Also, tonight couldn't happen without the support from UNICEF, especially Ms. Mariana. So we also would like to thank you for your support. And okay, now it's officially started. We are here for the 10 years anniversary of AIESEC. So 10 years ago, that was 2006, right? Any of you here remember what happened in 2006? Not a court, AIESEC was accepted, of course, yeah. But in 2006, you remember how was Vietnam look like? How was your life look like? Who you were? What were you doing? Well, there's something for sure. I remember. 2006, I was in my sixth grade. 2006, Vietnam has joined WTO. Yeah, I made some research. Donald Trump was not the president of the US. And also, in Japan, there was one girl decided to come to Vietnam. And her name was Asahi. So here is a video for the full story.
In 2004, I had a talk with a friend. Vietnam's economy was rising up. Many Japanese companies invested a lot of money. Then I got an idea that if we are successful to get support from these companies, maybe we can establish AIESEC in Vietnam. My name is Asami Ando. I'm the MCVP in charge of Vietnam expansion of AIESEC in Japan in 2006. We came to Vietnam because it is a very special country. It is beautiful, from the north to the south. Every place I stepped my foot, the scenery was breathtaking. It is cultural rich, with all kinds of traditional food and family customs. It makes the country unique. It is dynamic. The city was getting bigger and bigger, and lively with many industrial, business, and social activities. But it is also vulnerable. As a developing country, Vietnam citizens, especially the children and the women, are unprotected against many social issues. But it is also young. 28% of the population are between the age of 18 and 25. And they are the ones that will shape the future of the country, the status quo, and lead the change needed for a more progressive nation. We place our confidence in Vietnamese youth and believe that their leadership is the fundamental solutions. To solve the countries and the world is.
So 10 years has passed since Asami Ando and Ritika stepped their feet in Vietnam. So AIESEC in Vietnam was formed thanks to the support from AIESEC in Japan. Some of you may not know, but AIESEC in Japan fully funded AIESEC in Vietnam for the first 2 years. And they also has one MCVP fully in charge to take care of the Vietnam expansion in their first 3 years in a row.
So today we cannot have Ms. Asami, Ms. Ritika, and all the members of the founding generations here with us, but as they are still watchers through the live stream, so we want to take this chance to actually give a big thank you to the founding generations. So thank you, Ms. Asami Ando and Ms. Ritika Joshi and AIESEC in Japan for believing in AIESEC Vietnam. And thank you for embracing all of the geological and all of the cultural challenges for bringing AIESEC to Vietnam and to nurture the first ever generation of AIESEC in this country. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Arigatou gozaimasu. If you are watching, and so proud of you. Before 2012, 20 and 2010, well, fewer, 2008, and who has been here since the first day? I guess most of us do not really know what really happened during the first years of AIESEC in Vietnam. So in this special occasion, I would like to bring back some memories 10 years ago, and we would love to introduce you a very special history teacher.
Yes, of course. Who's going to be a better
history
teacher?
Please welcome Dave Man Day Han, the first president of AIESEC Vietnam.
Of peace and fulfillment of humankind potential. She later on was created a team with two other amazing girls, Brigitte and Rie, to start to recruit and train the first generation of AIESEC in Vietnam. I have been asking them many times, why do you want to bring AIESEC to Vietnam? And they said, the only way to create peace is facilitating the understanding. In different countries, in different races, in different religions, with that vision in mind, they have brought the first 30 members into this organization, trained and inspired them. We had our first local conference in Vũng Tàu, and we have learned
history. We will never forget the contribution
and the support from our national board advisor. They actually is the person who keep our organization relevant with the world. So personally, I want to meet Mr. Milton Nebuyar, who is the first national board advisor member and also my personal mentor. So he had taught me that never let money prevent you from following your dream. Because if you dream about it, you're gonna find a way to make it happen. And he also the person who helped us to get the first partnership with Unilever to make sure that our organization is financially sustainable.
I love the fact that there are a group of students along and try to make a difference, to contribute, to develop themselves. It has great events and great projects.
I've been really encouraged by your resilience to changes, your resilience to challenges. You have been very persistent. Your leaders and members have been very solutions-minded. I'm very, really surprised that even sometimes that you are able to overcome the challenges that you face.
I liked two things about AIESEC in Vietnam. One is it was a very pragmatic team, and the second, it was a very determined, very idealistic, and very get things done.
Các bạn là những người rất là nhiều tham vọng và tài năng và có tầm nhìn, nên chị rất thích là mong muốn làm sao mà có những cái chia sẻ, có những cái đóng góp để giúp các bạn vươn xa hơn.
For Unilever, we having many AIESECers joining our company each year. So my impression about the quality of AIESECers is extremely good, and I really love you too, because that is really the group who represent all of the best of Vietnamese students. But the most important today is about the spirit of openness, willingness, and hunger for learning, and also passion to make the country, Vietnamese society become better and better.
Very enthusiastic, full with passion, and very dynamic group of students in Vietnam.
I always feel like AIESEC forever young. The way we work, the way we dance, the way we think about the future or setting goals for ourselves, we always think big and we always striving for excellence.
All of that information and history and knowledge, and especially customer information and partner information, gets lost every year. And I think that's something that AIESEC in Vietnam really has to work on and improve.
One is financial discipline and financial management. The second big thing is how to be able to maintain partnership relationships with corporations and organizations throughout the years.
So of course, first thing first, you have to be up to date with the student insight and bring that into your agenda every single day.
You seem to change your leadership every year. So every year I get to work with a different set of people, and all very young and very passionate and very enthusiastic. But at the same time, I think that's sort of a drawback. Sometimes mission need to be implemented for not just a year, but the plan needs several years to reform and to be implemented and then to take effect.
So my wish for AIESEC in the next 10 years is to work hard at creating an AIESEC memory, an AIESEC history that future generations of AIESECers can use and not have to spend so much of their time recreating the past.
I wish similarly spectacular growth in the next 10 years, and obviously I wish very good experience for every single AIESEC members.
Và chúng ta sẽ suy nghĩ về cái chung, một cái gì đó tầm nhìn lớn hơn, có cái sự kết nối của các thế hệ trong AIESEC, làm sao tạo ra những cái dấu ấn khác biệt, những cái dự án quan trọng và khác biệt để giúp cho đất nước, giúp cho các thế hệ sau này.
I really have a big wish that the generations of AIESECers become very successful in the future. They can play very important role in wherever they work right now. I wish that you can create more and more and better next generation of AIESECers and contribute significantly to the leadership agenda of Vietnamese youth, but also to the bigger picture of the nation.
What I wish that AIESEC could be is to have a more continuity in the leadership from year to year.
So how about bringing about 1,000 members, 1,000 AIESECers in Vietnam and 10,000 in change to be achieved in the next 5 years or 10 years of Vietnam. So I also hope to see AIESEC Vietnam to be recognized across generations, organizations and also the government in the near future.
I encourage you today to continue to dream. Dream big. Dream as much as you can. Make a difference in many, many things. Be mad. You need to know what is the end-to-end process and how to finish strong.
The VPHR of HSBC, who always helped us to simplify all of the complication, all of the presented problems, and who always remind us to always focus on the outcomes.
And another very special one is Ms. Nguyễn Tâm Trang, VP of HR of Unilever, who's really useful whenever we need you. And strengthening our philosophy of leadership, and especially being purpose-driven, a purpose-driven leader. Thank you.
And the next person that we would like to send our thanks is Mr. Lê Hồng Phúc, the Chief Human Resources Officer of Novaland Group. Mr. Phúc has played a very important role, and very active role. He attends every VOA meeting, and he is very community-oriented, very dedicated, very supportive, and very helpful whenever we reach out to him. So thank you very much, Mr. Phúc.
And another AIESEC champion is Ms. Hà Cao, Country Director of Education First. She is always energetic and very optimistic, And our pool of ideas grows so much whenever we talk to her.
And of course, to our very, very dear MCP, Ms. Wu Tianhe. She is now the COO of VNHR. So it's her. She stays very close to us, and she always gives us a supporting hand, a really active hand in improving our talent management, our development, people development, our projects, giving very valuable ideas. And she has been also an amazing connector between AIESEC and AIESEC Alumni Association. So thank you very much, Ms. Khan.
If I be all the member of the National Board Advisors to come on the stage to receive our sincere appreciation. Please welcome.
Please welcome on stage our National BOA. We would like to invite Ms. Mai Thi Han, the first president of AIESEC in Vietnam, and also Ms. Thai Thi Cung Thao, the current president of AIESEC in Vietnam, to come on stage and show our gratitude. So thank you so much for your commitment to our growth, your patience, your belief, and your willingness to challenge us to become a better generation of leaders. Thank you very much.
So proud of you.
So.
Ventures in this room. Mr. Do Đức Chung, Deputy General Director at Pomina Steel Corporation. Ms. Sophia Tam Le, Brand Manager, Home Care at Unilever. Mr. Đặng Hoàng Trung, Instructional Designer at Pace Institute. And Ms. Lin Le, Sales Representative as Hyundai Hàn Quốc. It's also amazing for us to have your companion in one among the most challenging moments ever in our history. We could not remember how many calls and how many emails and consultancy meetings that we had together for Global Youth Summit 2015. And thanks for being here with us, being there with us, being here with us, and for still supporting us whenever we call you. Thank you.
So now we would like to invite all of the Global Youth Summit mentors presenting here in this room to come on stage and receive our lovely present as our gratitude.
We also would like to invite Mr. Attila to join us this time. Yes, you have been also helping us a lot for GYS 2015. Thank you so much.
So we would like to invite Mr. Attila.
One more time. Ms. Phuy Mon Tan, Mr. Đỗ Đức Chung, Ms. Nguyễn Trần Quỳnh Anh, Ms. Đường Thu Hương, Mr. Phạm Phú Ngọc Trai, Mr. Đặng Hoàng Trung, Ms. Linh Lan. If you're here, please come on stage. GYS without these people, guys. And it will be very difficult for AIESEC to come through 10 years of embracing challenges without the accompaniment of our national partners who have completely been there with us at least half a year to many activities. They're not only provided financially support, but they also push us to strive for the better and to keep being relevant by playing an effective role in connecting youth to other stakeholders. So among over 200 companies has engaged with us over the last 10 years of AIESEC in Vietnam, our deepest appreciation goes to Unilever, Prudential,
Vietnam Esports,
HSC,
British Council,
Nelson,
Totan,
Suntory PepsiCo,
Chuck Street,
Take Home Back,
Crab Soup,
and Standard Chartered.
And of course, our deepest gratitude also goes to Ms. Marianne and the whole UNICEF team for supporting us a lot during our first Youth Speak initiative. So thank you, UNICEF, as well.
Thank you for being here, Marianne.
So I would like to invite all of the people who are here today on the stage to receive our sincere thank you, appreciation. So please welcome on stage the representative of Unilever,
Prudential,
Vietnam Esports,
HSC,
Totan,
and Nelson.
We also would like to invite Ms. Marianne to participate on stage.
We have always been known by many young students, youth organizations, companies, through big forums and external events like Youth to Business Forum or Youth Speak Forum. But those are just a few of the ways that for us to develop the youth. But in AIESEC, we put our heart and our main focus in one unique mission. Do you know which mission it is? Which mission it is?
Yes, of course, right? It's developing youth leadership through exchange. So through the years, how was our exchange products evolved and what has it like become to make an impact on Vietnamese society? So for now, I would like to welcome on stage Ms. Khanh Minh and Mr. Viet Quang to share about the impactful stories of our exchange program. So please welcome.
Where are you?
Any you?
Where are 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 you?
Already decided to bid for this conference. got it. We got it.
To the hotel so that we can secure some slot for the only attendant there. But at that time,
we come to the year after that. So actually, after the global youth summit happened, we have a lot of challenges both legally and financially. And actually, AIESEC in Vietnam become an entity in debt to AIESEC International. So every year, we have to pay back a certain amount of money to regain our full membership. But it doesn't mean that it stops us from doing what we truly believe in. It's to do a change, to create more leadership experience for young people, not only in Vietnam, but also all over the world. So come to the next MC team, MC 15-16, we continue to do whatever we believe in to make the change happen. And finally, we reach a new milestone that in May 2016, AIESEC in Vietnam officially delivered more than 1,000 exchange annually. And also, thanks to that, again, this time, we won not only one, but two regional awards for the incoming global volunteer and the incoming global talent in the regional conference in Shanghai.
And give it up to MC Hanno and MC Hanno for this huge, like, really amazing award. We are in debt, but we are not, it doesn't mean that we are stop growing and people can see that. So, I'm here to represent the youngest generation of ASEAN in Vietnam, from 16-17. So, after 10 years, starting from 3 people, we now have been 7 local chapters and 1 official expansion. We have more than 700 members, and we are locating 3 biggest cities in Vietnam, which means that we are reaching more and more and more to Vietnamese people and making more and more impact to Vietnam society. So for this generation, we ambitious to become the global leadership, the youth leadership movement, being accessible to everyone, everywhere, growing disruptively and shape what we do around the world. I still remember one sentence I wrote in my application form for the local chapter, local vice president of ASEAN in Ho Chi Minh City. This one sentence. I wish that every single experience I deliver. After all, the app Browning shared the story to all the network. Because all of the story worth sharing. All of the story is a life-changing experience. So it's worth sharing. So it with me every till now, after like 2 years, it's still with me now. The motivation for me, and I believe it for all of you, to still working on the change, to still supporting the change happen. Yeah, so thank you everyone to be in the journey with us. Thank you everyone to choose AIESEC personally, because after all, it is possible. So I would love all of you to have a quick check in your bag, in your gift bag. So the OC prepare a very special gift for you. If you find something, can you show me?
how to face with my problem, how to improve my personal skill, and how to lead myself.
Thank you, AIESEC, for this opportunity.
Thank you, AIESEC, for making me be a global citizen.
We're so proud of you. Joining with us tonight, we would like to welcome Madame Tong Le Thien. And Ms. Ha Gao, Country Director of Education First. Thank you so much for making time out of your schedule to join with us tonight. Thank you. Okay, so, one of the biggest reasons why we're here tonight is to reunite and also to connect different generations of AIESEC in Vietnam. So now is the time for you to do it. I would like you to stand up and look for one person. All of you stand up and look for one person that you have never met before, you've never known, or one person that you have known already, but you always but you never really get to know about each other personally. This is your chance. So pick one favorite person in the room and get back to your seat. You have 5 minutes. If you already found your partner, you can come back to your seat and start the conversation. If you already find your partner, please find a seat and sit down. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, AIESEC! If you hear me, clap one, clap. If you hear me, clap two, claps. Three, claps. If you already found your partner, please come to the seat and sit down. Close your eyes, thank you so much.
Close your eyes
and get ready for some flashback. Here we go. It's a beautiful Saturday night tonight, isn't it? And we're all here together in this room.
It is very rude to attend the AIESEC 10th year anniversary. Today is a very special day, right? So this morning, when you wake up, what was the first thing in your mind? Was it about your work? Was it about someone? Or you didn't think about anything at all? And then, what was the first thing that you did today? Do you have to work on a Saturday? Yeah, but some of us just enjoyed a really relaxing day. And on the way to this venue, did you notice what happened on the street? On the street, were there any traffic jam? Yes. Were you stopped by any handsome policeman? What happened? Did you notice?
And driving along the streets every day, have you ever noticed how much the city has changed? How much the streets has changed? The people, how much life has changed since the day you first came here? For most of you, I believe. And the most important thing is how much you have changed.
How much you have changed since the day you entered university? How much you have changed since the day you graduated from the university? since the day you got your first job? Or even for some of you, the day you got married?
Do you still remember those days? Do you still remember yourself on those days? How were you on those days? Probably changed a lot, right? So what actually changed you? What actually changed you that much?
What actually changed you? Was it all the classes that you have attended? Books that you've read? Or the movies that you've watched?
What changed you? Was it all the jobs that you have done? Was it all the inspiring people that you have met? All the places and countries that you have traveled?
So what actually changed you?
Thank you. Please open your eyes.
Please open your eyes now and look at the person sitting next to you. Look at your partner. Such a beautiful face, right?
Okay, we have the biggest question for you now. And you don't have to answer to us, but just tell it to the person right next to you. What was the impactful challenge that changed you the most up to now? Tell them the impactful challenge that changed you the most. Thank you.
So the space is yours now. Please enjoy your
life.
Cái này cũng hơi bị khó, vấn đề là dịch vụ gì.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Who find the story from your partner was really impactful, challenging, and inspiring? 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, a lot of you. Who think that your partner's story is the most shareable story? Like, it's worth sharing, the most worth sharing. Share-worthy, what's the word? I don't know, sorry. Okay, I would like to invite some of you to share your partner's story. Or if any of you think that you really want to share your story, please raise your hand.
I saw a hand raising at the end of the room already. Oh, really long
time. Yay, Jenny. Okay, introduce yourself, your partner, and his story. What was the name of the website that you were mentioned? Sorry, one more time.
Besere.com.
Thank you so much. Next time if you want to go somewhere, you know, besere.com. One more story.
Oh.
My name is Pablo. Used to be an AIESECer here since 2012 to 2014. And I want to share the story of Khan. Khan is now the Khan, you need to say hello. Khan is now the second year student at RMIT. And I think Khan's story is not unique, but that's a good thing. And that's why I want to share it, because I think it represents the story of almost everybody here. And I think that'll explain why having AIESEC in Vietnam is so important. So Khan shared that before joining AIESEC and before joining the university, she was a shy, young girl. She said, how do you say? Simple. Oh, not, you didn't say boring, simple. that just go to study and then stay home, right, most of the time. And then she joined AIESEC, and suddenly her life changed. Because she had to go to meetings, work with the teams on projects, organize events, go to the sessions, conferences. She went to Thailand for a conference. So her life completely changed. And that all these challenges that she faced during the work in the projects in AIESEC in general made her start growing up much faster, right? So I think that's the story that I've seen so many in AIESEC here. And I think that's why it's so important that AIESEC gives a chance for students to grow up and be ready for the life after university. So congratulations to everybody who holds the same story.
Thank you, Baba. I really like the reason why you chose her story to tell, and that's true. It's not unique, but that's important because it's similar to the story of every one of us here.
So as I have told you before in the opening speech, I believe like everyone sitting in this room have their own version of an AIESEC impactful story. And I think like during this time, like you have also had a crazy look about like one of many thousand stories that AIESEC has made an impact on. And because tonight, like it's very special because we do not really have like only us AIESEC girls with us in this room, but we also have like the presence of our special guests from many, many different partners organizations that have helped AIESEC throughout the years. So for now, maybe I would like to hear an external opinion about like what we have shared through the night and also like in this particular session. Maybe I would like to invite like Ms. Marianne from UNICEF to have a short word to share with us. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Kini. So I'll try to make it short. How are you all? Everything good?
Yes.
Congratulations to AIESEC in Vietnam. I'm actually really honored to be here today. Actually, I am. It's great to be here to celebrate your 10th anniversary. My first encounter with AIESEC was actually Paul, but I didn't know he was part of our AIESEC, so okay. That doesn't count. My first real encounter with AIESEC was Ginny. Because he came to my office here in Ho Chi Minh City and wanted to talk about what is AIESEC, and I was very impressed about all I heard, you know. I was like, wow, this is a really important partner for UNICEF. I work for UNICEF. UNICEF works to ensure to help government and civil society and everyone else to ensure that all children have the same rights, so that the rights are implemented, so that rights are upheld for children, no matter whether they are disabled, whether they are marginalized, where they are in the world. In fact, indeed, also in Vietnam, of course, very important. So for me, coming from UNICEF, I thought, wow, AIESEC can actually give something to us. It's not about what I can give to AIESEC, really. Because we, as UNICEF, really wanted to start to reach out to youth-led organizations such as AIESEC, because you are so very important for the social agenda in this country. It's not just about growing up and doing good in business. You know, it's not just about earning money in this life at all. It's also about contributing to your communities and to the country, to this great country. So for me, you know, meeting Jenny and later Pa, Sabrina, and a lot of you have been through my office for the past year, actually. I've seen such potential, and it's such a pleasure to talk with you. So, you know, I'm very busy with lots of meetings, but when AIESEC calls me, I take my time and I sit down, because maybe you think that you learn something from me, but in fact, I learn a lot from you as well. Because you help me to understand what's going on in Vietnam, you know, what's going on among young people, what are young people thinking about, what are you worried about, what's your concerns, and what are your hopes, what is it you want to see for this country, right? So how is it you want to move the agenda forward in this country? Because, you know, we can talk about the Sustainable Development Goals, and we can talk about this strategy and the other strategy, but when it comes to it, it's really about you as change makers. It's about you being this new generation. It's about you having children very soon. It's about, it is, you know, don't wait so, as many years as I did, right? But, you know, it's about you having children very soon. So it's about you looking at those children and thinking, wow, my God, now I also don't just have to work for myself to make, you know, my future better. I also need to look around, I need to open my eyes, I need to realize, you know, what this country is all about. And I think that reaching out to young people for UNICEF as a partner, AIESEC as a partner, is a very powerful thing to do. So I'm looking really, really forward, you know, to, for the years to come, to work more with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Ariana.
Thank you, Ms. Marianne, for your meaningful sharing and also for your promise to work more with AIESEC in the future. And of course, we have a very special person as well sitting right next to Ms. Marianne. And it is our honor to have you here, so we would like to hear a few words from you, from Madam.
I'm pretty sure all of us would be very happy to hear some thoughts from you.
Good evening. There's a lot of energy in this room. I don't think I can add more energy. But I'd like to invite you to just slow down and let's think together. 5 minutes, just 5 minutes. First, I think that it's more about your own empowerment than about the notion of youth leadership. Frankly, I attend a lot of these events. Everybody wants to be a leader. Now, if you, all of us are leaders, who's doing the dirty work? You see what I mean? So we should perhaps shy away from too much talk about we are going to become leaders, you know, to feel good. I'm sorry, I'm trying to be really candid. So let's call it self-empowerment. So you can self-empower yourself to be a doctor, a physician, to be a pastry maker, to be a designer, to be the president of the Socialist Republic of Vietnam, why not? So on and so forth. That's first thing I'd like to share with you. Let's talk about change our vocabulary. It's very trendy. Everybody wants to be leaders. Right, but better to say, I'm going to empower myself to do and become what I have identified or I have chosen to be the goal of my life. Right? So this is the first sharing, my first sharing with you. Listening to all of you also, I think that the very important thing about the stories we've just heard is making a difference. Young people like to be individual or even individualistic, to have style, to have personality, to leave a mark, you know, you see what I mean, to dress differently and so on and so forth, to stand out. So my take is it's more important to make a difference nobody will forget you when you have not left the sea. See? So ask yourself, what kind of difference can I make? So the story about the Vese Yaje, that's it. Why did he come back? And frankly, I myself, people have been asking me, you had a comfortable life back in Paris. Why did you come back to Vietnam during the war? And why are you still here? My answer was simple. I said, well, if I had stayed in Paris, I'd have a regular, comfortable, nothing special kind of life. Whereas coming back here, there have been difficult moments in all aspects. But there is not a single day I have not felt that I do make the small or the bigger difference. So my second sharing to you is for each of you, if you want to be empowered, once you are empowered, then the next question you need to ask yourself is, what kind of difference do I want to make? You see? Ask yourself that question. For example, have you ever asked yourself that question? Have you? So, what is it?
The person that I want to be in the future is actually work more in the agriculture aspect, in the agriculture industries, because that's the way what I see in my hometown. Because people there, the way that they do agriculture is not very well planned and well constructed. So that's why I want to make a difference. So so that's what I want. I know that it's not my major in the university, not something that I study, but I know that the journey is gonna be very hard. Yeah, that's something that I want to do. Because even though the choice that I made to be the president of AIESEC in Vietnam also, I think that myself is also like, while we are young, don't be like so money driven, do something good to something that I believe in, as my dad also shared, yeah, not to be money drive.
It's okay to try and get rich. The only issue is what for and how, right? But the choice about agriculture, I think it's great. It's great because now I relate back to everything I saw since I arrived here at 8 o'clock. I can see that all the messages that you project on the screen and you integrate into your stories is all about going out to the world. Of course, you need to go out to the world. But at the end of the day, you go out to the world. If you find yourself there, you stay there. But frankly, not many will feel at home far away in that outside world. And you will see, for most of us, sooner or later, we want to go back home. Or we want to, from where we stand out there in the broader world, we want to make a difference right here at home. And why should we want to make a difference here at home? Well, because, you know, it's more difficult here. It hurts more here, you know, and so on and so forth. So it's like, you know, you would want to help where it's more needed, right? Rather than helping where, well, they need you less. So again, I say, if you go out, then you need to know when, how you go back. And when I say go back, not necessarily physically, right? But going back here is in trying to see what you can do for Vietnam, for its people, for, you know, the ones you love here in Vietnam. So, in other words, is a two-way street. That's what I keep saying. Remember, it's a two-way street. And just forgive me commenting on the recent election in the United States. It's about that too. Globalization hurts even the rich countries and the rich societies. You see? So they also say, let's get back to the US. They say that in the US. So for us, it's all the more natural. You know? So my wish and hope that I would like to share with you is that you are the ones who are going to make that difference, that critical difference, if only you decide to do it. So AIESEC is great in that it offers you those opportunities that for sharing, for growing. AIESEC is also wonderful because some of you would never get out of your comfort zone if it were not for AIESEC. But again, AIESEC would be great even more if it leads you to look for other opportunities than AIESEC. You know what I mean? It's like saying, well, I like Hanoi a lot, but then you from Saigon, you go to Hanoi and then you stay there. Well, you need to find also other spaces, other frameworks, other networks. And so I hope that you will be able to spread AIESEC to other places. But my wish is that you show this two-way movement, you know, not just one way, because listening to you, it might give the impression this is yet another, outlet to your feeder to channel young people's hopes, aspirations, ambitions, curiosity to the outside world. Ask yourself, do I know my country? If you know your country as well as you try to know the world, fine. But if you're all eyes about the world, and the first question you're being asked about, your society, the traditions, the specific values of the Vietnamese way of life, and so you can't explain them even to your expatriate friends. That's something. If an expatriate friend asks you, what's the meaning of Tet? Does it compare to other, celebrations or special days, festival days in other cultures? Then you should be able to explain, right? So with that, I think I should stop because I don't want to make it long. We've had a long evening already, but so I came just to, as someone who cares about what young people in Vietnam, what they think, what they feel, what they dream of, and what they are capable to do. Well, as a very sort of a trite sentence, but true sentence is the future of Vietnam is in just not your hands, but in your minds, shoulders, your hearts, particularly in your hearts. If your heart is not there, then, as I say, you want to emigrate, fine. It's better to have somebody emigrate and return with a warm heart 10 years later than having somebody who is in Vietnam and dreams of Hollywood and Los Angeles all the time. You see what I mean? So, my message to you, wishing you all the best to all of you. And I'm really heartened to see so many ladies. The gentlemen should think, why are there so few gentlemen? Not too bad, but I attend a lot of activities, sort of networking, getting together, exchanging and all that. And I see a lot of ladies and very few gentlemen. So, gentlemen, why?
Thank you. You know, there's also like a really like special question in AIESEC. Like, we have a really mismatched numbers of boys and girls, like female and male.
That's a real problem in AIESEC.
We need to think about that.
Thank you so much for your thoughtful sharing. It really touched me personally. Thank you. And now is a gift from the organizing team, the very last one.
Happy 10 years anniversary. My name is Milena Nguyen. I'd like to use this chance in order to share with you how AIESEC taught me to challenge and to embrace challenge and to have the right attitude, take the right action. It helped me to grow so much, not only in my AIESEC years, but also in life as well. I felt that I was under a lot of pressure. However, I did not let that pressure crush me, but I used that to turn it into an inner motivation that I really need to learn everything that I needed to know in order to be the best.
So thank you, AIESEC in Vietnam, all my teammates, leaders, members, interns, advisors, mentors, partners for all those years, with meetings, conversation, coaching, trainings, successes, mistakes, to make who I am today, and to keep fighting for the better, for myself, my family, to change one life at a time. So happy birthday, and congratulations, AIESEC in Vietnam.
AIESEC in Vietnam, happy 10-year anniversary of AIESEC. Thanks to AIESEC, experience will actually help me a lot in building up my own confidence. And you know, like it just somehow trained me to say yes to challenge, and then I'm gonna figure out a way how to do that, how to solve it. And congratulations for the 10th year of the anniversary of AIESEC in Vietnam. I love you all and see you someday very soon.
Hey guys, so this is Aso, your president of AIESEC in Vietnam in 15-16 term. This night is celebratory, you know, 10 years, it's been a, you know, birthday, decade. As much as it is celebratory, I also want to leave you with this question. What kind of stories do we want to be telling in 20 years from now? Right? So, again, apologies that I couldn't be there in person. Have a great night. It's been an amazing decade. AIESEC Vietnam, this is for you.
We were born ready, ready to be free, chasing every thrill we could see. With our eyes steady, waking to a dream, aching to be thrown in the ring. If nothing comes easy, as long as we're breathing, we'll go all the way or go home. We were born ready, wherever it leads, what we have is all we need. 'Cause if it's fast or slow, all I really know is I'm gonna enjoy the ride. And if it's hard or soft, before we get off, I'm gonna enjoy the ride, enjoy the ride. If it's fast or slow, all I really know is I'm gonna enjoy the ride, enjoy the ride. If it's gets light and if it's fast or slow, all I really know is I'm gonna enjoy the ride, enjoy the ride.
And now is the photo section.